106, as appointed for the 21st evening.
Thank you. first lesson is written in the second book of Samuel, chapter 15, verse 17. When King David departed, all his household followed him, except 10 concubines, whom he left in charge of the palace. At the far house, the king and all the people who were with him halted. His own servants then stood beside him, while the Kerethite and Pelethite guards and Ittai with the 600 Gittites marched past the king. The king said to Ittai the Gittite, "Are you here too? Why are you coming with us? Go back and stay with the new king, for you are a foreigner, and what is more, an exile from your own country. You came only yesterday, and today must you be compelled to share my wanderings? I do not know where I am going. Go back home and take your countrymen with you. And may the Lord ever be your steadfast friend." Ittai swore to the king, "As the Lord lives, your life upon it, wherever you may be, in life or in death, I, your servant, will be there." Here ends the first lesson.
Oh. The second lesson is written in the Gospel according to St. John in the 11th chapter, beginning at the first verse. There was a man named Lazarus who had fallen ill. His home was at Bethany, the village of Mary and her sister Martha. This Mary, whose brother Lazarus had fallen ill, was the woman who anointed the Lord with ointment and wiped his feet with her hair. The sisters sent a message to him, "Sir, you should know that your friend lies ill." When Jesus heard this, he said, "This sickness will not end in death. It has come for the glory of God, to bring glory to the Son of God." And therefore, though he loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus, after hearing of his illness, Jesus waited for 2 days in the place where he was. After this, he said to his disciples, "Let us go back to Judea." "Rabbi," his disciples said, "it's not long since the Jews there were waiting to stone you. Are you going there again?" Jesus replied, "Are there not 12 hours of daylight? Anyone can walk in daytime without stumbling, because he sees the light of this world. But if he walks after nightfall, he stumbles, because the light fails him." After saying this, he added, "Our friend Lazarus has fallen asleep, but I shall go and wake him." The disciples said, "Master, if he's fallen asleep, he'll recover." Jesus, however, had been speaking of his death, but they thought that he meant natural sleep. Then Jesus spoke out plainly, "Lazarus is dead. I'm glad not to have been there. It will be for your good and for the good of your faith. But let us go to him." Thomas, called the twin, said to his fellow disciples, "Let us also go, that we may die with him." Here ends the second lesson.
I believe in God. Descended into hell. Let us pray. Ministers with righteousness,
and make thy shores a river shining.
O Lord, save thy people,
and bless thy inheritance.
Give peace in our time, O Lord. Almighty and ever-living God, who for the more confirmation of the faith didst suffer thy holy apostle Thomas to be doubtful in thy Son's resurrection, grant us so perfectly and without all doubt to believe in thy Son Jesus Christ, that our faith in thy sight may never be reproved. Hear us, O Lord, through the same Jesus Christ, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, now and forevermore.
Amen.
Almighty God, give us grace that we may cast away the works of darkness and put upon us the armor of light, now in the time of this mortal life in which thy Son Jesus Christ came to visit us in great humility, that in the last day when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the quick and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal, through him who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, now and ever.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Savior. Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let us pray for the Queen. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, King of kings, the only ruler of princes, we beseech thee with thy favour to behold our most gracious Sovereign Lady, Queen Elizabeth, and so replenish her with the grace of thy Holy Spirit, that she may always incline to thy will and walk in thy way. Grant her in health and wealth long to live, and that finally after this life she may attain everlasting joy and felicity, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for the order of the garter. God save our gracious Sovereign, and all the companions, living and departed, of the most honourable and noble order of the garter.
Amen.
Almighty God, who hast given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and dost promise that when two or three are gathered together in thy name, thou wilt grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come life everlasting.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us bless the Lord.
Evensong came again this afternoon from the Queen's Free Chapel of St. George, Windsor Castle. The choir was directed by Christopher Robinson, and the organist was John Porter.